Hello friends, welcome to this video. I am Dr. N.M. Sivaya. Today I am going to explain working capital, its concepts and types on the subject financial management. It is highly useful for PG students and also for the competitive examinations. Now the first question, what is working capital? Working capital is also called net working capital. Working capital means the capital used for running day-to-day operation of a business. This is one meaning. Another meaning, working capital also means a minimum amount or a capital which is used to run the business successfully. Or working capital also refers to amount available to operate the business. Next meaning, working capital also means the difference between current assets and the current liabilities. Therefore, working capital is defined as the excess of current assets over current liabilities. So the formula is total current assets minus total current liabilities is equal to working capital or net working capital. There are two objectives for working capital. One is to maintain sound financial health or to maintain sound financial position. The second one, to operate the business successfully. What are the concepts of working capital? Working capital concept is consisting of two items. One is called gross working capital. The second one is called net working capital. So these are two concepts of working capital. What is gross working capital? Gross working capital is nothing but total current assets only. So when you take the total current assets, that will give you the gross working capital. What are the examples for current assets? Cash on hand, cash at bank, bills receivable, sundry debtors, stock in trade, in marketable securities, and prepaid expenses. So these are the items will come under the term current assets. So total current assets represents gross working capital, GROWS, gross working capital. Second concept, namely net working capital. Net working capital is also called working capital, another name, simple name, working capital or net working capital, both are same. As I already said earlier, working capital formula, total current assets minus total current liabilities equal to working capital. So what is net working capital? Same formula, total current assets minus total current liabilities. What are the examples for current liabilities? Sundry creditors. Current asset, sundry debtor. Opposite, sundry creditor, current liability. Bills receivable, current asset. Opposite, bills payable, current liability. Bank overdraft. Short term loans. And outstanding expenses. So these are the examples for current liabilities, namely sundry creditors, bills payable, bank overdraft, short-term loans, and finally outstanding expenditures. So these items will come under current liabilities. So net working capital means total current assets minus total current liabilities. Next question. What are the different types of working capital? Working capital is broadly classified into two types. One is called on the basis of the concept and another one is on the basis of the time. Next, first one, on the basis of the concept. As I said earlier, two items. One is gross working capital and another one is net working capital. So these two types of working capital will come under on the basis of the concept. What's the next division? On the basis of the time. It is broadly classified into two. One is called permanent working capital or fixed working capital, and the other one is called temporary working capital or variable working capital. So these are the two types of working capital will come under on the basis of the time. Now, what is a permanent working capital? Permanent working capital is also called fixed working capital. So what's the meaning of the term permanent working capital? It means total current assets of the business. So current assets, without current assets, business cannot run. Business cannot be operated. So every organization requires minimum current assets. That is, it may be in the form of cash or inventory. So without the cash and inventory, business cannot run. So that is called permanent working capital. So permanent working capital is nothing but minimum amount of current assets required for running the business, for day-to-day operation of the business. This is called permanent working capital or fixed working capital. The second type, variable working capital or temporary. Temporary working capital is also called variable working capital or fluctuating working capital. Another name. What's the meaning of the word temporary working capital? It means working capital over and above the permanent working capital. So over and above the permanent working capital, that amount is called temporary working capital or variable working capital or fluctuating working capital. For example, permanent working capital 1 crore, temporary working capital over and above 1 crore, that amount is called temporary or variable or fluctuating working capital. This temporary working capital is further classified into two. One is called seasonal working capital and another one is called special working capital. What is seasonal working capital? Working capital required during a particular season. For example, winter. In case of winter, the demand for umbrella or raincoats will increase. So we need more working capital during particular season. So that is called seasonal working capital. Another one is called special. Yeah, an organization may need additional capital during festival time, the special working capital. Festival, Diwali, Christmas, Ramzan. Under that circumstances, the demand for the product will increase. So that organization has to maintain additional working capital to meet special demand or special working capital during festival time. So temporary working capital can be classified into two. One is called seasonal and other one is called special. So these are the various types of working capital. So simply speaking, working capital consisting of 6 types. What are they? Gross working capital, net working capital, permanent working capital, temporary working capital, seasonal working capital, and special working capital. Next question, what is operating cycle? Operating cycle is a vicious circle. It begins with cash and also ends with cash. How it begins and ends with cash? Cash is converted into raw material, because with the help of cash, we buy raw materials. So cash converted into raw material into work in progress, work in progress to finished goods to sales, sales means debtor to cash. You see the circle? So it begins with cash, from cash to raw material to work in progress to finished goods, finished goods to debtor and debtor to cash. So this circle rotates. This is called operating cycle or vicious circle of working capital. So simply speaking, operating cycle begins with cash and ends with cash. This is called operating cycle. See you in the next video with other interesting questions and answers. Till then, goodbye.